In this tutorial, we're going to learn advanced ways to optimize model and texture details to extract the best edges possible and generate better tune and sketch lines in Flair for Maya. I'm Henriette from Artineering, and we develop artist-driven tools for stylized rendering. Let's get started. In previous tutorials, we learned how to erase inlines generated by Flair and even draw our own arbitrary inlines. However, instead of manually erasing and drawing lines everywhere, we can also focus on optimizing the extracted edges to generate the best lines possible out of the box. Additionally, knowing how lines are extracted allows you to optimize models and textures for them. To generate lines, we run an edge detection algorithm on three different types of data: depth, normals, and color. So whether there is a difference with neighboring pixels for each data type, an edge is created. All these edges combined later form the lines that we see in Flair. Believe it or not, we're using derivatives like you learned in high school. They're automatically calculated, but we thought it was worth mentioning in case you wondered if you would ever touch high school math again. Back to edges. We cannot consider any value change to be an edge. There is a specific limit to the difference in depth, normals, and color that needs to be exceeded to extract an edge. For example, if you might only consider a depth difference exceeding 1 meter to be an edge. This limit, in technical terms, is called a threshold. Each individual threshold within Flair can be set in the Flair Global node. To see these attributes, select the Flair Globals node by clicking on Globe in the Flair shelf. Underneath the Line and Sketch attributes, expand the Advanced Controls layout. To see what they do, let us first set the Flow Edge Threshold and the Color Edge Threshold to 1.0. This will effectively remove lines generated in normals and color differences, keeping only the lines generated from depth differences. The last attribute, Light Edge Blend, can be ignored for now until we talk about the Color Edge Threshold. Let's concentrate on the first attribute, Depth Edge Threshold, which marks the limit at which a depth difference of neighboring pixels is considered an edge. The smaller you set the depth edge threshold, the more depth-based lines will appear. This can go to the point of seeing every individual polygon recognized as an edge. The higher the threshold, the more depth difference is required to extract an edge. So if you only want lines as silhouettes around objects, you can increase the threshold to do so. Just keep in mind that the depth will depend on the world scale attribute too, so make sure it is set correctly to your scene dimensions as well. If you like how you can customize thresholds, give us a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to our channel with a bell icon to be notified about future tutorials like this. Back to thresholds. Let's set the depth edge threshold very high to get rid of depth-based lines and concentrate on the next attribute, flow edge threshold. The flow edge threshold works in a similar way, but depends on the normal differences between neighboring pixels instead of depth. The smaller you set the flow edge threshold, the more normal-based lines will appear. This can also go to the point of seeing every individual polygon recognized as an edge. The higher the threshold, the less sensitive the lines will be to differences in normals. So if your assets need high-frequency normal maps and you're seeing lines everywhere, you can remove the lines extracted from them by setting a higher threshold value. However, you could also use normal maps to your advantage and design them so that you can clearly generate edges in different parts of objects. To concentrate on the last threshold, color edge threshold, let's first get rid of normal-based lines by setting the flow edge threshold very high again. The color edge threshold works again in a similar way, but depends on albedo color differences between neighboring pixels. The smaller you set the color edge threshold, the more lines you will get from small color differences, potentially picking up on albedo texture noise. The higher you set the value, the less sensitive the edges will be to color differences. Therefore, this threshold is useful to set higher if you do not wish to have lines generated from albedo textures or if these textures contain a lot of grunge or noise. The final attribute, Light Edge Blend, dictates how much lighting should contribute to the albedo color. Setting this attribute to 1 would lead to lighting edges from cast shadows or cell shading being recognized by the color edge threshold. In the end, the right combination of all these attributes can optimize the lines that Flair generates for your look. Now, I do hope I didn't get you dizzy from all this information. You not only revised some high school math and learned how lines are extracted from depth, normals, and color information, but you also got your hands dirty by setting custom thresholds to generate just the lines you want. With this knowledge, you can optimize your lines, your models, and your texture to render some amazing line work. Now that we've covered everything there is to art directing and customizing lines in Flair, it is time to learn how to best render these lines and even combine them with other renderers. Thank you for watching this far. If you love what we're doing, make sure to purchase a commercial license or become our Patreon to use Flair without resolution limitations and have your name appear in this beautiful list of credits. Render you on the next one.